New research time. Let's be real, we all can work on our sucky sleep habits. The sad thing is we know sleep impacts so much, like our work, our studies, our social life, and yes, even our gains. Personally, my sleep has been pretty bad all the way back to when I was 10, and I always had these super puff dark circles under my eyes because of it, so in high school, I googled how to fix it, and one of the top answers was to put frozen spoons on them for a few minutes every day, so I did, and unbelievably it didn't work. Still look like a panda. Anyway, the point of this video is that there's now new research on sleep and its impact on something you might not have thought about. Can poor sleep cause you to gain weight? Let's check it out. This study is actually a systematic review, or a type of research that looks into multiple studies on a subject to draw a stronger conclusion. Of course, the studies relevant here are about sleep and weight-related data, in which the researchers found 50 randomized control trials meeting the criteria. They even looked into data on hormones, like the fullness hormone leptin and the hunger hormone ghrelin, to see if they might influence the results. Overall, they found that poor sleep had effects on multiple related factors. Energy intake, or the amount of calories subjects consumed, trended higher with poorer sleep, with this slightly affecting women more than men. Interesting. In terms of the type of food people end up munching on, the data suggests that people were more likely to snack, especially on more fatty foods, while carbs and protein intake remained largely unaffected. The data also generally skewed towards poor sleep hindering subjects' ability to lose weight, most likely because of the increase in energy intake, since the data on energy expenditure, or calories burned, does not seem to be heavily influenced by poor sleep. Some other factors like appetite, hunger, portion sizes, and the number of eating occasions all generally increased with a lack of good sleep. So overall, poor sleep sucks. No question about it. Now though, we know it sucks even more. But you're probably asking, Mr. Picture Fat, why does poor sleep cause these issues? And the answer is, we don't really know, at least not for sure. Remember those hunger and fullness hormones? Well, they didn't really change in the data, so hormones, at least not leptin and ghrelin, might not be the reason. Right now, one of the prevailing beliefs is that poor sleep might lead to alterations on neuronal pathways, or brain pathways, that regulate reward behaviors. This might cause people to seek out more snacking, particularly of calorie-dense foods. More research on this, of course, will be needed. It goes without saying now, but really, really try to improve your sleep hygiene. Try to go to sleep at the same time each night. Get off your phones. I have a video on that. Get 7 to 8 hours of sleep per night, more if you're younger. And if you just have a lot of trouble getting good sleep, then it might be time to go talk to your doctor about it. That's exactly what I'm doing now. Poor sleep sucks. And hopefully you and me can start taking it seriously enough so that we can focus less on sleepy brains and more on muscly gains. If you found this video helpful, then please give it a thumbs up and share it with your poor sleeping friends. Subscribe for more, and as always, don't forget to get your protein.